This game is huge for both coaches and both programs. Dick and I expect one player to step up and provide us with one shining moment in today's third-round game between the North Carolina Tar Heels and the Houston Cougars.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Cougars might be in over their heads in this one, Dick.
Absolutely. Here are some things that they have to do if they're going to have a chance to win. First of all, make their outside shooters into drivers. Attack them. Be aggressive on the D. Second, don't let your man beat you to the rebound. And lastly, keep it simple defensively and play as a unit.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. Questionable shot selection there.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Kicks it out. He dials long distance. Off the rim and no good.
Pushing that basketball.
And the ball goes out of bounds. And Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play.
He fakes the shot. The small forward takes the pass. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. They work the perimeter, trying to pack it inside. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Fed the low block. Here's a nice face-up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face-up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
He'll regroup the offense. Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's one you take for the team, Brad.
Garrison steps to the line for the first time. Cashed it in. Wow, the screener is back to school on that pick. On the dribble, gives it up. Number 42 with the fake. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. For two, it'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
This is a one-man show right now, Brad. This is supposed to be a team game.
Intercepted. Pushes it up. Moving it around the perimeter. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Looking for a good shot.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
And he missed. He puts it in with contact and all. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Dick at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick TO, baby.
The power forward gets the ball. Inside. I think they're trying to make a statement. I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
Working it around the perimeter. Shows patience waiting for the reset.
The defender's doing a great job of applying more pressure.
He looks at the hoop. Now they'll bring it up. On the outside. He takes a three. Way off target. And a momentary look from three-point land.
Look at that spacing.
Inside. Top of the circle. They work it around the perimeter. Controlling the ball. Stolen away. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. They work the perimeter. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Goes up for two.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer. There he is. Strips the ball loose.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Manley in the paint.
Double team now, bad angle. They say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling act here and turns it over.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
The small forward takes the pass in the paint.
There's the screen up on top.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. He shoots from right of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Leans in. Basket falls despite the contact.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
On the outside. There's the pick. Tries for two. They still don't score.
There's the trap.
Another turnover.
You're not talking apple turnovers either.
Oh, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
They're working around the perimeter. And he'll kick it back outside. He shoots from left of the circle. Way off target.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate. Great anticipation defensively.
Garrison is eager and excited to compete.
Hey, can you blame him, Brad? He's getting it done.
They run it up into transition for the bucket. Drains it. Looking for a good shot. For two. Perfect. perfectly executed.
Let's take a look right here.
He attempts a jump hook.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
There's a double team waiting there. And they get the turnover.
2-for-1 opportunity.
The shooting guard gets the pass. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
They move it into the front court. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Shot clock is dead. Number three is admired by the fans. Listen to that ovation.
The people here really appreciate what he brings to the table.
He goes to the line. First shot, no good. Second shot is good. On the outside. The post flashes up high if he wants it. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's crawling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
At halftime, the Cougars are down by 4. Houston has allowed a lot more turnovers than I'm used to seeing them have in a first half, Dick.
I must admit it, I'm still trying to figure out their game plan. Do they think they can win without any offensive possessions? It would take a miracle for that to happen.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Welch in the paint. Gave it up. And the ball goes out of play. You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all had good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt play is.
For the bucket. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn. I tell you, he didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
A high screen. Unloads a three. Off the rim and no good. He gives him the fake. Gave it up. Kicks it out.
Step out on that screener.
For the deuce. Makes the shot. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear it clearly down here. The coach is stressing, go inside, go inside. They've been affected all night long that way. What an asset to have, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down to the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I'll tell you, really a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under the move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Manley receives the ball. Here's a nice face up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
He looks for the bomb. Way off target. The point guard handles the pass.
That's a high post screen, goes to the lane.
That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Intercepted. The point guard takes the feed. Up fake. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Off the rim and no good.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
They're working around the arc. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you. Coming inside.
With a rejection.
That has to be intimidating, Brad.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. Off target. Now the turnaround jumper.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
Fakes it. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
The small forward handles the feed. Shoots from outside. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Tries to get the D to bite. He shoots from left of the circle.
Wow, used the screen perfectly, but the shot didn't go.
He fires it up. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their voice is beginning to fade.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
Thanks, Aaron. The power forward with the ball. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Tries for for two. Doesn't go. Alley-oop for two. And he scores despite the hack. He goes for the trifecta. North Carolina are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Taken away. The ball goes out of bounds. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved. They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you. Take a look right here. He explodes to the basket.
He wants the crowd to get pumped up. Dick, he is feeling it.
Pump them up, young man. Pump them up. If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Well, partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Gets it to go. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Finger roll.
Pressure on that basketball. That's the key to their defense. Pressure the ball, deny the wings. Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
Robs him of the ball. Count that as a personal foul. I think it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot. Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively.
Ball movement, get that good spacing.
Steals the ball. Time out on the court, so let's go court side. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. They might try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dip.
That might not be a bad idea.
On the outside. Picks off the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. They work the perimeter. Picked off. Shot clock is dead.
Dump it inside.
Looking for a good shot. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
And yet another foul. Well, there's a turnover situation. I guess most notable, the number of points off turnover.
Well, Mr. Nestler, that's why you want to take care of the basketball. You want to protect it. Turnovers will result in points being scored at the other end. That's one statistic which coaches always monitor.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And the clock stopped with a foul.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And there's a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, knowing when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their teams.
It's good. He can't get one to fall.
This is a very important possession. They got to score to stay alive.
We'll see who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. He attempts the three. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
North Carolina just wanted it a little bit more in this game, and because of that, they're going to live to play another day, Dick.
Hey, they're on their way to the Elite Eight, Mr. Nestler, where they'll be joined by the seven best teams in that nation.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler.